2017 records only 17% of startups had female founders. And why do you think this number is so low? And what could be the reasons? So try and find some answers to these questions. I'm going to talk about today my journey into tech world and my experience in technology companies, about how women in technology in general, and also share about my recommendations for female entrepreneurs and for people who are women who are working in the technology fields. Then I'd like to also take this opportunity to tell a little bit about what my company does. Giftable is an online platform that finds the perfect gift for companies of any size, based on the profiles that companies choose again. So what does this mean is, imagine you have a company and you have X number of clients. You come to us, in contact with us, browsing giftable.ie, and you tell us about your clients. And based on this information, we find the perfect gift for your clients. We add a card, we wrap them beautifully, and add a personal touch into it as well, and then send it to your clients for you. By doing this service, we save 2.5 hours on average per gift for the companies, so that they could use this time for their own business. And of course, we have 100% satisfaction rate from our customers. So we are happy to say that as well. So for more information, you can check out giftable.ie. As I said, I would like to share about the things that actually made me come here, share about my experiences in technology. Before I found Giftable, I worked in multinational companies for 10 years as a software engineer, and mostly in most of the areas in support, integration, and testing. And I'd like to also talk about a little bit how I actually get interested about technology when I was growing up. From a very young age, I was very, very interested in new technologies, new gadgets, and new tools, and etc. But growing in a small town in Turkey in the 90s, as you can imagine, there wasn't much gadgets and tools, etc. around. So I was very lucky to have my first laptop in 1999. And then I decided to be a software engineer. So after I shared my idea about this with people, well, because they asked, like, what is it about? You know, they haven't heard of such a thing before, and they said, you know, maybe just choose something that is very regular, like maybe teaching would be very ideal for women, and especially after getting married. Well, I was very surprised to hear this type of things, because in my future, when I grow up, I always imagine a world that I could send a comment to my oven at home, so that I could have my pizza ready when I arrive from work. And what people were talking about, doing minding kids and, you know, getting into this type of work, teaching, and etc. and etc. We were definitely not in the same mindset, let me say like that. And later on, because I didn't see a role model for myself back home, I always wanted to be one and inspire other girls like me who couldn't find a role model for themselves. It's easier for now, but it wasn't very easy back then. And I actually asked myself, what should I do now to get there? And what would my role model do if she were in my shoes and if she had to live in a little town in the 90s at the age of 15? What she would actually do to get there. Then I said, okay, maybe learning English would be something really good to be able to reach out international resources. So that's what I did. I started learning English, and in 2005 I came to Atula IT as Erasmus exchange student and to software engineering department. And finally, 3 years later, after that, I landed into my dream job in Ericsson Athlon as a female software engineer. So I was over the moon, so happy to land into this job. And well, this wasn't the beginning, actually. This wasn't the end, but it was the beginning for me. Well, I would like to also share about like working in big companies in corporate world. It's great experience. You could learn a lot of things from them. I learned a lot from working in big companies. However, if your major is something very specific, you could, you know, if you are not lucky, you could also end up working the same thing but not able to learn and add things into yourself. So I was very personally interested in product management, so that I wanted to drive a software product from A to Z. And I wanted to learn about, you know, inside out, digital marketing, data analytics, you know, how to get a customer interested about as well. You know, many things I wanted to experience. So because of that, I founded Giftone as a side project when I was working full-time as a software engineer. I'm so happy that I did it, to be honest, even though it started just like a side project. Because the things that added me, the reaction from people that I got was absolutely amazing. I really, really, appreciate that. Also, my learning curve just started to grow exponentially. The things that I wouldn't be able to experience, it just happened to be I started learning something very new on different field every day. So that was really amazing for me. And lastly, meeting with many amazing women who have their own businesses in technology world was one of the greatest things as well, I have to say. Well, these people who founded technology companies, interesting enough, most of them don't have technical backgrounds. So that's one of the things that, you know, we should keep in mind, that you don't have to have a full competence on something if you want to step on something. Mm-hmm. So that's one of the things I wanted to mention. Also, these people, these amazing women who started their own businesses, we have our own products in many different places, serving in many different ways, and we are really proud of it. And the most beautifully, I have to say, we all support each other. That's what I really, really love about. Now, I'm going to share my observation about women in technology that I've seen when I was working in full-time in my software jobs, and also plus dealing with female entrepreneurs time to time. First thing I want to say is, we as women, we underestimate our skills, don't we? We want to be approved and supported. When you want to buy a dress, for example, you take a picture and send to your friends on WhatsApp, right? You want to get approved. You want to hear that they like it, you know, go ahead and buy it, you know? But if you hear something, maybe one negative comment, that could put us off. We unconsciously believe it sometimes. So that, you know, the things that we have been thinking could be just destroyed like that. But if I listened to that person who wanted to suppress my dreams, I wouldn't be here today making this speech. I completely believe in my skills and abilities, even though I didn't have much back then, I mean when I was young. So I think believing is something really, really important. Also, I would also recommend to surround yourself with positive people. There are so many negative people out there in many areas, you know. So why do you waste your time with negative people? So around you, who supports you, who inspires you, who has done similar things like you did or you are trying to do. For example, for me, TED Talks are great inspirational ways. And one of the things I like most about TED is people talk about their failures. You know, they take starting point their failures, and they take this as a lesson learned. And you get to learn from their mistakes. You don't have to repeat that mistake again. That's great. Also, as women, I admit I was one of them as well. We hesitate to ask. I give you an example. I wanted to go to a conference in London, and I was so hesitant to ask my manager, you know, can I go for that conference, because the budget for the team was already spent and it was nearly end of the year. I kind of knew that, you know, he was going to say no, but he was going to find a way to say no to me. But one day I dared to ask, and I got a very short and quick answer. He said, sure. And I was surprised to get this answer, and I have been thinking about that for so many days. Why didn't I just simply ask him before? So, this one of the things I admit that put me back as well. And as you know, in technology world, it's mostly man dominated, and men are fairly direct people. They have to be told what the things are. You know, you can't imply them, otherwise it doesn't work. So for women, as women, I learned that as well. I wish I had asked my managers and people earlier to get you know the things that I wanted. That's one thing. As Helen mentioned as well, you know, investing in yourself in technology is really, really good. If you stop learning, you are left behind. And as the technology evolves, you know every day something new comes up. But it could be an opportunity for you as well. You could be an expert on something that people didn't have much, you know, information about. Maybe they could definitely, you know, prefer you because you have a little bit more experience than them. So we could use this opportunity too. I think last thing I would like to mention is, as we women, we sometimes forget about ourselves. And because of the responsibilities that we have all on our shoulders, we tend to live our passion more than men do, even within a workplace. I'm going to give an example again. In my workplace, with women, we mostly talked about, like, for example, wearing a skirt felt very dressy at office, because many of the engineers only wear, you know, hoodies and runners and etc. They feel a bit awkward wearing that. I mean, we all, you know, women, why don't we feel awkward wearing a skirt at a workplace? We should be ourselves. We should be proud of what we are with our likes. That's what stands us out. So I personally believe in that, bringing something from real you to work or to wherever you are is really important, because it's real you, it gives you confidence, it stands you out from things. I go to work every day, I wear my scarf, and because this is something from real me, and this is, this is what I am. So because of these things, adds definitely to your productivity. So for women, I advise, go and wear your girly stuff, high heels, jewelry, go ahead and wear them and be authentically you, and be definitely proud of it. Also, I'm sure authentically you will definitely improve the 17% into much higher numbers. And after you achieve that, make sure you give it back and support other women in technology. Thank you very much.